Please listen carefully.
Three of us were actually in the by-election, and so it does feel in many respects that we were just here having the same conversations. But they have great meaning, and the process is important because it speaks to a participatory democracy which should inform provincial policy and legislation. I wanted to tell you quickly, it has been a pleasure to serve this community for the last 19 months as your member of provincial parliament. We brought a social worker into the constituency office. We are doing significant casework, and we are tracking the issues that come through that office. The top five will be of interest to you. Access to health care with a focus on mental health, renters' rights, utilities and the rising cost of utilities, dental care, particularly for children and for seniors, and housing security. Having had this experience of helping people navigate through a very complex social policy network, this informed our platform. Many of you know that I entered politics primarily because I'm passionate about public education. I think it's the great equalizer in society, and it is worth fighting for every step of the way. On the education front, of course, you also have childcare, which is a key component to ending poverty in the province of Ontario, particularly for women. Our platform speaks to $100 million to stabilize childcare, as the full-day kindergarten had a negative impact on child care. We also have a key component of affordable housing. I've been the critic for economic development in the last 19 months, and I can tell you it is very, very hard to get a job when you do not have housing. So our commitment of $294 million for affordable housing, with a focus on inclusionary zoning for affordable housing and supportive housing for those who cannot live independently, is a major factor. Transit, I think Stacey put it best, transit is the great equalizer as well, and people need to have access to transit, it needs to be affordable, and they desperately need it in the core and in the suburbs. Finally, we've made a $60 million commitment to community hubs. Schools are in their communities, you help pay for them, the infrastructure is there. The $60 million commitment will open the doors for seniors, for families, for children, and I think that this speaks to healthier communities. One final thing, we need to plan to be healthy for the future. The latest Ontario Municipal Board decision, which overrules our democratic rights, the OMB is unelectable, unelected, unaccountable, and they have overruled your democratic rights for planning. We cannot afford further urban sprawl. So on June 12th, I respectfully ask for your support. I'm willing to fight for you if you're willing to fight for me. Thank you.